वेलकम टू रैत ऑनलाइन स्कूल एजुकेशन 21-22 सदगुरु गार्गी महाराज कॉलेज कराट गाइडेंस बाय प्रिंसिपल डॉक्टर मोहन राजमाने सर स्टैंडर्ड 11 सब्जेक्ट बुक कीपिंग अकाउंटेंसी मायसेल्फ पटेल मैडम फ्रॉम एजीएम कॉलेज कराट वी आर गोइंग टू सी नाउ द चैप्टर नंबर 3 ऑलरेडी वी आर स्टार्टेड विद द डॉक्यूमेंट्स सोर्स डॉक्यूमेंट्स एंड द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ वाउचर एज वेल एज द स्पेसिमेन ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट्स Now we will see the main important part of this chapter, which is journal. About the journal in this lecture, today we are going to see about the meaning, definition, importance, as well as the utility of journal. Let's start with the point number one, as usual, with the introduction. Everyday businessman perform a large number of transactions. As we know very well that transactions are performed by the businessman in the day-to-day work. These transactions cannot be remembered by a businessman at a glance. Therefore, these transactions must be recorded in different types of books. So, the transactions which are done by the businessman, he cannot remember every day whatever the transaction he has done. So, therefore, these transactions must be recorded in the different types of books. He keeps different accounting records for this. The number of books depends upon the size and nature of business as well as the volume of transaction. So, what books he is going to prepare over here? It totally depends upon to the size and nature of the business. Which size it is there, that's a small size, large scale business or as well as volume of transactions, it totally depends upon that. But important books of account, which must be maintained by every businessman, are journal as well as ledger. Today, we are going to see about the journal. And the next chapter, we will come to know about the ledger. So from this, you must have understood that every transaction, whichever is being done in the day-to-day, by the businessman, it is not easy to the businessman to remember each and everything. So always he has to maintain the records and he has to maintain the important books which has to be maintained by every businessman, which is journal. So totally the number of books depends upon the size as well as the volume of the business. Journal is a book which is employed to classify or sort out the transactions in the form of convenient for the subsequent entries in ledger. Always journal keeps record of daily financial transaction, so it is also known as the book of original entry. So journal is book which is employed to classify or sort out the transaction in a form of convenient for the subsequent entries in ledger. So why this sentence means what? From journal you have to do the ledger. So always when journal will classify, will sort out, so for the ledger it will be more convenient to enter and to prepare. Journal keeps record of daily financial transaction. That's why journal is also known as the book of original entry. Further, we will continue with the introduction. When the journal transactions are recorded in the journal, it becomes a journal entry. That means when day-to-day transaction occur and businessman keeps all the record, all the transactions record in the proper important books, that recording of journal transactions in the journal is known as journal entry. Journal entry consists of the name of debit and the name of credit involved in the financial transaction with a brief narration. That means, you know, we have seen the last lecture about the, in my last chapter, we have seen about the analysis of the transaction. In that, you have seen that every transaction has two aspects. From that, two accounts which are involved, and one is the debit, another is the credit. So, journal entries always consist of the debit as well as the credit financial transaction with always a brief narration. Journal is a book in which the business transactions are first recorded in a chronological order, that is date-wise, in the order in which take place. That means always remember that whenever transaction takes place, it always recorded in the chronological order. That means sequence-wise, one below another. If the transaction took place on 2nd of October, then it took place at 5th of October, then we will go according to the sequence, right? First we will write about the 2nd of October, then we will write the 5th of October, like this. So always journal should be recorded according to the chronological order. So generally the different types of books of accounts are maintained by the businessman for recording the business transactions. So various types of books are always been maintained by the businessman while he is recording the business transaction. So he maintained two types of book. First is primary books and the second is secondary books. Primary book includes journal proper and special journal, which include purchase book, sales book, purchase return, sales return. Then we also know about the bill receivable book as well as bills payable book, and secondary book means ledger. So understood everyone? Two types of books are always being maintained. The first is the primary books, which is included in journal, special journal, proper, purchase book, when purchase is there, sales book, purchase return, sales return, bills receivable, bills payable. And the secondary book is all about the ledger itself, which we are going to see in our next chapter about the ledger. So that was the whole of the introduction about the journal. Let's move ahead and go with the next point, meaning. In the meaning, the word journal is derived from the French word jour. Jour, which means a day. The name only is that. That means the day-to-day transactions, whichever it is there, has to be recorded properly in the chronological order. That has been said as a journal. So journal is derived from the French word jour, which means a day. And day means, from this you understood, that journal means a daily record. So a journal contains a daily record of business transactions, hence it has been named so. As soon as transaction takes place, its debit and credit aspects are analyzed and first of all recorded chronologically, that is in the order of their occurrence. That means how it takes place, it goes according to that, how it occurs. Journal is a book of original entry, or you can say as primary entry. So what is a journal? Journal is derived from the French word jour, which means a day. So journal means a daily record of business transaction that takes place with the debit credit aspects, which are analyzed, always recorded in a chronological order as per their occurrence, that means as per how it takes place. And journal is also said as the book of original or prime entry. That was the meaning of the journal. Let's move ahead and go with the definition. Two definitions have been put forth. The first is according to L.C. Cropper, and the second definition is according to Dictionary for Accountant written by Eric Kohler. Let's go with the first definition. According to L.C. Cropper, a journal is a book employed to classify or sort out transaction in a form convenient for the subsequent entry in the ledger. So what L.C. Cropper say? He say that it is a book, journal is a book, which is employed to classify, to sort out the transactions. Of course, you are going to classify each and every account is to be classified properly. You are going to sort out the transaction in a very convenient form, subsequently entry in the ledger. That means journal or journal entry which you write, further you have to do about the ledger. So on the base of journal, ledger is prepared, it means today. According to the Dictionary for Accountant written by Eric Kohler, it is said as a journal is a book of original entry or recorded transaction, not provided for in specialized journal. So according to the Eric Kohler, it is a book of original entry as recorded transaction, which is not provided for in specialized journal. That was what two definition put forth by Elsie Cropper as well as dictionary for accountant written by Eric. Further, we will see the importance and utility of journal. As you all know very well, journal is an important book in bookkeeping. All business organizations keep the journal. The importance and utility of journal is as follows. So a journal is very important book in bookkeeping. All the business transactions keep the journals because it is convenient to them. You can have to record the day-to-day transaction. So the importance and utility is as follows. Point number one is, this is the principal book of account, which include all types of accounts of business. What is journal? Journal is the principal book of account, which include all the types of accounts of business. Now only we have discussed that we have to classify all the various types of account in this business. Number two, it shows all necessary information regarding the transaction. So always remember, in journal, all the necessary information regarding the transactions are shown. Number three is, journal has date-wise record of all the transactions with details about account. It helps to understand the events when it took place. Why you have to write the date-wise record of the transaction? Because when you write the details about the account, always when it will make you understand the events when it take place. So whenever the events which have took place, at that time you will come to know that yes, on 3rd of Jan this transaction was done. Because when you write a journal, you give all the details about the year, about the date, which we will see in the specimen. So journal gives you date wise record of all the transaction with details about the account and helps you to understand the events when it took place. Then the fourth one is, journal is subsidiary books in which all the day-to-day transactions are recorded first in chronological order. So what is journal? A journal is a subsidiary books in which the day-to-day transactions are recorded first in chronological order in debit and credit form with the amount of each transaction. Then the fifth is, accounting procedure is always followed on the basis of accounting documents. What is followed over here? Accounting procedure. The narration provides a brief explanation about the transaction. Point number six is that whenever you write the journal entry, every time you write the narration below that, which starts with the word being. So you always, when you write a journal entry, you follow the accounting procedure, you follow the golden rules of accountancy, which is denoted to the personal account, real account, nominal account. And when you write the narration below, whenever you write the journal entry below that, you write the narration, it helps you to increase the clarity of every transaction. That means a clear-cut view you are going to get with the help of narration. Number seven, it helps to find and prevent errors. So if any errors occur, mistakes, if it is there, immediately you come to know with that. Number eight, it helps to check the arithmetical accuracy of the transaction. And nine is, it helps in preparation of final account. Remember that journal is the base. As it is said, the book of original entry. As it is also said, the book of primary entry. So journal is the base, which is very important to be maintained by every businessman. Because from journal, ledger is prepared. From ledger, trial balance is prepared. And on the basis of trial balance, final accounts is prepared, which consists of two accounts and one statement. The two accounts are trading account, Second is profit and loss account. And number three is the statement which is balance sheet, which conduct liability as well as assets of the business. So always journal helps in preparation of the final account. That was the 9 point which is there for importance and utility of journal. Further, we will see the format of a journal. You can say specimen, you can say format of a journal. The journal format which is there in front of you, first you have to give a title, journal of whosoever book is there, you have to give the title, journal of dash. Okay, that means the name of that person whose book is maintained will be there. Then further, it is divided into 5 columns. First is date, second is particular, third is LF, fourth is debit amount, and the fifth is credit amount. In the date, you will write the year, then you will write the month, and then you will write the date. Okay, first what is you have to write? Year. Then you will write the day month, then you will write the date. Okay, then is the next one, particular. In the particular, name of the account debited, debit you have to write, DR, initial. Next line you have to write to name of the account credited. So up on the first line you have to write the debit, means which account is debited should be right on the first line, debit. Next line, which account has to be credited should be written on the second line. Okay, so always remember, if suppose I gave you the example, rent account debit to cash account. So in the first line, rent account, leave some space, you have to write DR dot. Next line, you will write to cash account. Okay, then next below that, we have to write the narration. Narration starts with the word being rent paid. And we have to close with the bracket. Narration is very important because narration gives you the explanation of the above journal entry. Next column is about the LF, ledger folio. Next is about the debit amount. And the next column will be about the credit amount. Okay, so this is the format of the journal, which is very important. You all have to know that. Divided into 5 columns, date, particulars, LF, debit amount, credit amount. Got it? Next, we will see about the GST. GST, which is a goods and service tax. What is GST? We will see. GST stands for goods and service tax. Before GST, every state had variety of taxes levied at different stages of trading. Taxes that existed before were excise duty, custom duty, VAT, entertainment tax, central sales tax, service tax, octroi, etc. All these taxes are included under GST. That is why GST is one nation, one tax, one market. GST started from 1st of July 2017. So from this you must have understood what does you mean by GST. Further is the finalized GST rate cards, which is there for various items, which you can see in front of you, which is divided into 4 columns. First is 0%, that means no tax. First column, 0%, which you can understand that no tax will be imposed on item. Like example, it is given eggs, milk, buttermilk, curd, okay, natural honey, fresh fruits, vegetables, flour, besan, bread, prasad, then salt, bindi, sundur, stamp, many things are there, newspaper, bangles, handloom, printed books, etc. Chicken, meat, etc. Everything on that, 0% GST. Next is 5% GSTs, items such as, it is given as slimmed milk powder, branded paneer, frozen vegetables, coffee, tea, spices, pizza bread, rusk, then kerosene, coal, medicine, cents are there. Many things are there which come under 5%. Third column is about 12%. 12% in that it comes frozen meat products, butter, cheese, ghee, dry fruits in packaged form, animal fat, then fruit juices, then various types of namkeen, Ayurvedic medicines, tooth powder, agarbatti, okay, umbrella, swing machines, cell phones, which all comes under 12% tax slab. Okay. Next is the 18% column. Most items are under this tax slab, which include flavored refined sugar, pasta, cornflakes, pastries, cake, preserved vegetable, jam, sauces, soup, ice creams, then instant food mixes are there available, mineral water, then I'll tell you camera, then speakers, monitors, on that 18% GST. Okay. Next is about the fifth column, 28%. 28% are there on various items, like example, chewing gums are there, chocolate not containing cocoa, waffles, wafers coated with chocolate, pan masala, aerated water, deodorants, shaving creams, aftershave, hair shampoo, dye, sunscreen. Then many things are there, vacuum cleaner, shavers, hair clipper, all are under 28%, etc. So final GST rate cards for items which I have discussed with you, which goes into five column, 0% means no tax, 5%, I've said 12%, 18%, 28%. That was all about the GST. So today we have seen about the journal, intro, meaning, introduction, meaning, then we have seen the definition, then we have seen the importance and utility of journal, then we have seen the format of a journal, and at last we all have seen about GST and about the GST rates. Enough for today. Thank you very much. We will continue with our next lecture further.